Awesome.
You got control of it?
Really? Yeah, I got control. I got control.
All right, here we go.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Go Blue.
Don't hit each other.
No. Hey, wait.
Yes!
So the Global Space Balloon Challenge is an opportunity for the entire world on one weekend to launch weather balloons. We're able to organize this challenge in coordination with Stanford and the Massachusetts Institute of Technology for other teams ranging from father and son combos to students at schools and universities, to young professionals, to people who used to hold the altitude record and want that record back.
Is it 7:15?
We're actually on time.
It's exciting to see your instruments work. It's also frustrating at times to see your items not work. But that's a lot of what engineering is. It's debugging and fixing your systems. That's how you get to understand them even better, is by going through these testing phases.
Stop right there. Okay.
There's teams who are out there right now who are just trying to get the tracking down. They're just trying to get the, how can I safely launch and safely recover these payloads from the operations of filling the balloon to tracking it and to recovering it. We have other teams who are setting up sensors, Geiger counters for radiation, temperature, humidity, pressure, your basic atmospheric weather data that you would want from these flights. The Global Space Balloon Challenge is definitely going to create a buzz within the high altitude ballooning community. And with the type of research that you can do on these high altitude balloons, because you have these young professionals and young adults who are learning all of the technology that you're going to use in the space industry or in computer science, even in atmospheric sciences themselves.
What? We're just north of the balloons.
Okay, we're trying to get our internet back up, but whoever has internet first, you can take the lead position. Over. And we got it.
5 years ago, a team of students in the Space Systems Engineering program decided to make a high-altitude balloon team. 5 years later, we're able to make our own radios. We're able to send up our own commands to the balloon. We're able to control where the balloon will land instead of the balloon controlling us. And so every year, there seems to be a different milestone of what you want to accomplish.
I just have 5 minutes, so...
Yeah. 5 minutes!